Welcome. We are Two Finger Spirits. We're going down the rabbit hole with Derringer straight bourbon whiskey finished in PX sherry cask.
My, what a peculiar place to have a party.
I'm the camera guy. I'm back here.
Camera shy, camera guy, my trusty companion. How's it going, buddy?
I'd rather not say.
Oh, come on. The wife has been nagging you?
No, she's been the best. God. I have the best wife in the history of wives.
She is something else, I'll tell you.
The dog, on the other hand.
Oh, man.
There we go, bottle kill.
Look at this. 2017 gold medal winner. 2017? What have you done for me lately?
I don't remember the rabbit hole in the Olympics. Let's look at this. So this is a port cask finish, right?
A sherry cask.
That's what I meant.
You know what PX stands for?
No.
I do, but I can't pronounce it, so I'll let somebody else handle that.
All right.
This is a rabbit hole. I guess they source their whiskey from somewhere, but it's undisclosed. It's pretty readily available. You can find it on a shelf everywhere. 93 proof, no age statement, mash bill. You ready?
Yes.
68% corn, 18% wheat, 14% malted barley.
So
nice color.
18% wheat, 14% malted. I feel like that's a pretty equivalent mix of wheat and malted barley. I feel like typically we see something heavier with wheat and a little bit less malted barley. So that's interesting.
Yeah, it's a nice smash bill. You like, the wife likes weeded whiskeys.
She does. She loves the weeded whiskey. She likes the Old Elk.
MSRP around 80.
Weller Antique 107.
What do you think of that color? Nice, dark.
Well, you could definitely tell it's been
dark rust, right? I don't know how long it's been in the sherry cask.
But it's definitely darker from it.
I don't know how long it's in any cask. No age statement, but it's a nice color. Really sweet nose.
You see the legs on it.
Definitely smell the sherry on it, right?
Oh, without a doubt. I almost get like a raspberry berry smell.
I get wild berries.
Yeah, some type of berry.
I get dark fruit. I get some light oak. The one thing I don't love about it on the nose is I get a cough drop. The Loudoun's cough drop.
I guess I can see that.
You get that?
Maybe a hint, but not overpowering.
It's
93 proof, so it's like it's not overwhelming.
It's pretty dark for a 93 proof.
I want to say because from the
sherry cask.
Yeah. Going for it.
Again, I get the sweetness.
That's a sweet one.
But I feel like it's almost an artificial sweetness, like a cough drop again. I'm getting the cough drop on it. I'm getting some light oak. I'm getting some raisin.
I definitely get the oak, the raisin. It's sweet though, like almost like a rum cask finish sweet. Like it's sweet, like, not the Angel's Envy sweet, but like a Breckenridge.
That was a rye, that Angel's Envy rye talking about, right?
But the Breckenridge one, like that type of sweetness, where it's like a hint of it, but it's like a little bit more than a hint.
I don't recall the Breckenridge one.
The Breckenridge. Yeah. Rum cask finish? Did we not do that one?
I don't know.
Well, wife drank it all.
This is pleasant. It's nice, but it's almost too sweet for me.
I feel like I can have one. I wouldn't pour two of these.
Yeah.
What do you think of the finish? It's short.
It's medium length. I wouldn't say it's short, but it's medium in length. The sweetness kind of yields at the on the finish, right? It yields to like the oak and a touch of bitterness, touch of some raisins. Not a touch of raisin, but I get definitely some raisins. I think the finish is my favorite part of this one.
The nose is my favorite part.
Really? The nose was a little too sweet for me. I don't want that sweet of a whiskey. The palate, I don't love the artificial Loudoun's cough drop flavor note that I'm getting. I can see some people really liking that, but it's just not the flavor profile that I love.
If you're into like the rum cask finish and the cherry cask finish, this is right up there with a little bit of the sweetness.
And we love the Rye by James E. Pepper that was finished in the sherry cask. That was one of our favorites.
I love that one. But I wonder if we would still like it.
I tried it recently, and I kind of feel like I'm drifting away from that flavor profile.
At the moment.
Yeah, at the moment. You know, you go through cycles. Slick wheel. Is that the word? Mm-hmm. Maybe. We'll go with that one.
What's the MSRP on this?
It's 80.
Way too much.
Yeah, I can get stuff that I like a lot better for that price point. This is the second time I bought this. I probably won't get it again. I kind of bought it because I really liked it the first time. And I don't love it right now.
Too bad we don't have any left we could have put in. Oh, no, never mind. That's a Rye. Never mind.
Yeah, it's priced too high. I wonder what it'd be like if I got a cash strength from them.
Oh, man. But I tend to agree here where $80, don't get me wrong, I like it. I would pour one of them, not two. It's really getting away from the flavor profile I prefer as well.
Yeah.
But it is enjoyable, I have to say. It is enjoyable. I would. It's the farthest thing from a drain pour, I'll tell you that.
Oh, yeah. I would
farthest
definitely,
thing. It's definitely, you know, definitely good.
I might not, if I had this on my bar, I wouldn't reach for it often. Well, you know, it's empty now. But maybe I did reach for it often. But I would save this for people that like that profile. Because there's people that would come over. I don't know. In my mind, I think of it as like a woman's whiskey. But I don't know why. Maybe just because it's sweet.
Maybe because it's sweet and it's purple.
Yeah.
I do like the bottle. I like the rabbit on the bottle. I tried to do the best I could when I took the shot in the beginning. I think you could see it.
The little bunny.
If not, go back to the beginning. You'll be able to see the bunny. Which is kind of cool. The shape of it's cool. I like the little ribbon it's got going on. I think it's a pretty bottle.
Got a nice fat cork, huh?
Dresses up that would dress up a bar nicely.
Yeah. Makes me look good. Got anything else you want to add about it?
Nothing can make you look good, I'm sorry. But no, but if you had this one, you know, tell us what you think.
Do you think people should like and subscribe?
It would be nice. You know, there's no pressure, but like, you know, you could always smash that like button.
Oh, smash it. John Muir, he's a wonderful, wonderful humanitarian.
And what did he have to say?
He said the clearest way into the universe is through a forest of wilderness with a glass of whiskey.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for joining us. Cheers.
Thanks for coming. Cheers, bud, everybody. I'm bringing sexy back. Yeah. The motherfucker don't know how to act. The things you lack, yeah. 'Cause you're burning up, I gotta get it fast, yeah. Take 'em to the colors. Come here, girl. Go ahead, be gone with it. Come to the back.